Alright guys, this is the stuff that you're going to need to make it. So first we'll start off with, you're going to want some shortening, either shortening or lard. I'm thinking that lard will work better since it's made with animal fat. But I don't have any lard, so I'm just going to use shortening. This stuff right here is already the mixed ingredients. A little bit of garlic powder, just a little bit of garlic in there. Always gives it a little bit of more, a little bit more scent. I did add a little bit of vanilla just to test it out. You're going to need a container with a lid on to put it in. Preferably something that you can dip your fingers in because it will get hard. So nothing in a squirt bottle because it won't squirt. A little bit of salt, doesn't matter if it is a container like that or just a salt shaker from your table. And the most important ingredient is your coffee. Right here I got Folgers medium roast. So what you're going to do is take some coffee and some lard, a lot of coffee granules, and you're going to mix the lard in. So you're going to take some lard, just dump it in there, little bit of dash of this, and as much salt as you want, it doesn't matter because you're going to be straining all the coffee and salt out afterwards. So I won't have any of the granules in it because I'll show you guys how to strain it out. So I'm going to mix it up and melt it, and I'll show you what it looks like as it's melted. Alright guys, as you can see, it's all melted and nice. What you'll notice is that the coffee granules will kind of be suspended and kind of floating, and the salt will kind of sink towards the bottom. What you want to do is just keep on mixing it after it's melted. Just keep on mixing it. You can add a bit of your garlic powder in now. I already added quite a few. So just shake a little bit of that garlic in there. Stir that in. You might want to add a drop of vanilla maybe. Just added two drops there. After you get your shortening melted, if you make this from scratch, what you're going to do is add in coffee. Pretty much, I would say about 2 or 3 tablespoons if you're making half a cup. And just to get as much in there, just so you get as much scent, because the coffee granules are going to get strained out. And another ingredient that you're going to need is a coffee, I don't know what they call those, but it's what you use in a coffee pot. So actually I can add a bit more coffee granules. The more the merrier. And I already had a ton of salt in here, so I'm not going to add any more salt. But I'll get the straining set up, and I'll show you how to strain. Guys, as you can see, I'm ready to pour my scent into this nice container. It's just an empty hair gel jar or cologne jar. What you're going to have to do is get a small strainer, like what you use for making draining macaroni and cheese or something. Put your coffee strainer into there. And then what you're going to do is you're going to slowly make sure that it's over your thing, and you're going to slowly dump it in. And just make sure that it all drips into your container. It might take a while. You just got to sit here and hold it, let it drain down. And you can even set it there if you want to. And just let it all drip down. You're just going to keep on doing that until all that's left is just big globs of coffee grounds. And I'll show you what the finished product looks like. Alright guys, finished product, just took it out of the refrigerator. One tip, instead of using the coffee stuff that you use for the coffee machine, just use a paper towel because it'll strain out faster. And after I got it all strained out, a little bit of grounds did get through, but this is what it looks like. It's kind of like a tan paste. It smells a lot like coffee. It smells really good. This stuff is actually edible, so a human can actually eat it, but I don't advise eating it. I did taste it. It tasted kind of like gritty, and it tasted a lot like coffee, actually. And just rub it on your jigs, especially on things with skirts. And the nice thing about this stuff is after you make it, if you get it on your hands, you'll find that it's very hard to wash off with water, which is actually good because then it will stick on your lures and it won't wash off right away. You could probably fish this for 2, 3, 4 hours with this on your bait, making over 1,000 casts, and it won't wash off. So It still does leave a scent trail in the water, though, and when the bass bite it, they will taste the coffee. So, and it does mask human odor, so it's really great. Just use soap when you want to wash it off your hands. I added a little label there just so I know what it is. But really great stuff, guys. Tell me if you like this video, and thanks for watching.